everybody. Something kind of really exciting happened in my life after I released these apps. First of all, it was exciting to make some money off of art. I mean, that's always exciting for any artist. But the bigger thing that happened is that I was approached by Björk in a very kind of understated English way. I got this email that began, "Sorry to bother you." You know, only you know, the English would begin an invitation to work with Björk like that. And she invited me to work with her on an app. And it turned out we were kind of working on along parallel lines, but you know, I had my idea was like this big, and her idea is like the size of the universe, literally. So she had worked for 2 years making the songs for this new album called Biophilia, which means, you know, love for life. And it begins in this kind of galaxy. So the galaxy has a number of constellations that you don't see in our universe. One of them is Björk's name. And the 10 other constellations each represent one of the songs. So what Björk did in this app is she created songs that each relate to nature, to music, and to technology. She wanted to unite those things. And if you're familiar with Björk's music, you know that her whole life she's been, well, actually, basically after the Sugar Cubes, she started using electronic music extensively. But really using electronic music to write music referencing nature and also bringing us closer to nature and emotions, you know, rather than further away. So this is the first project that was not a personal project. You know, her first 6 albums were about herself, her kind of emotional life and experiences. And then the 7th album is about something outside of herself. And for that topic, she chose everything else in the whole universe. So she needed some help with the universe part. The music is really amazing. And she had really strong concepts for each of the songs, but she didn't want to make videos. What she wanted to do was make some kind of interactive experience. And when the iPad was released, she realized this is the place. It's actually kind of funny, I'll show you, because the way she made some of the music for her app, for Biophilia, was with a precursor to the iPad. So this is a device called the Lemur. And she had these custom tools built for her that allowed her to... She actually wrote a lot of the music for Biophilia using tools like this that she had programmers create directly for her. So this is just a simple demo of her tool that she recorded. But she actually used this day in and day out and gradually created like the melodies, the structures, and the scales for the whole album. So Biophilia begins in a kind of grand way with a voice
Welcome
that I think
to Biophilia,
recognize.
The love for nature in all her manifestations, from the tiniest organism to the greatest red giant floating in the farthest realm of the universe. With Biophilia comes a restless curiosity, an urge to investigate and discover the elusive places where we meet nature, where she plays on our senses with colors and forms, perfumes and smells, the taste and touch of salty wind on the tongue. But much of nature is hidden from us, that we can neither see nor touch, like the one phenomenon that can be said to move us more than any other in our daily lives, sound. Sound, harnessed by human beings, delivered with generosity and emotion, is what we call music.
So listen to the whole thing if you can sometime, but I like to end on that part with Björk's definition of music, which is sound plus generosity. And I don't think anyone else could define it that way. So what Björk did is she invited me and a number of other developers to work together to create this app. So you can move around this world. It's a, you know, fully three-dimensional world. And you can zoom into one of the constellations to experience that song. It's also kind of neat because as you get close to these stars, you hear little bits of the other songs. And if you're wearing headphones, it's terrific because you actually hear them, you know, sweeping around your head. So Crystalline was the first single. And if we take a look at this app, it has a bunch of features and a main attraction. So one of the features is this traditional score. So it's a traditional musical score, and it shows you her music as it's been, you know, transposed into Western musical notation. Now, I think a lot of us, you know, if you were interested in music as a kid, you know, you buy sheet music from a band that you like, and you open it up, and it's really quite amazing to see that this thing I heard on the radio is made up of notes the same way, you know, Bach or Beethoven created music. It's also kind of frustrating because it's kind of difficult to read and understand. But if you do read music, or if you can sing, or if you'd like to try singing, this is like a karaoke experience, so you can sing along with the song. This one is actually can even be like a little lullaby. And you can also turn off the sound and just hear a click track, and then if you have an instrument, you can try to play yourself, you know, with a piano or with a violin and so on. Now, this isn't just a movie. It's actually a fully interactive score. Everything in the app is like this. Nothing is a pre-recorded movie. It's all, you know, fully interactive. Now, each app also has another form of score. So this is an abstract animated score. Having seen some of that work by Oscar Fischinger, I think you understand where this comes from. These are all created by a guy named Stephen Malinowski, and it's another way of visualizing music, where height represents which note, the blue spheres as they collapse represent singing, and of course there's a little undertitles with the lyrics. And again, this is interactive. You can even, you know, stretch it to see more of the song or less. And you may say, you know, this is just, it's merely a nice visualization of the music. But Björk actually prefers this version to the traditional musical score. So she actually plays exactly this during the concerts. She'll play this video, and it guides her and the other performers on stage to the notes in the song and also to the lyrics in the song. So it's actually useful. This is another way of looking at the apps, which is a kind of, you know, behind the 3D world menu. So let's take a look at Crystalline. So each of the songs has an app that's some kind of interactive experience. So Crystalline, you interact with by, you know, tilting the iPad. And when you tilt, you move this crystal. And you try to scrape other crystals off the wall. So you see I can capture an orange one. And then I'm supposed to capture only the colors on the right. So it's kind of game. And when I get out of a tunnel, I can then tilt to choose one of the others. Each tunnel represents a different part of the song. So there's only certain ways that the song can be strung together musically, although there are hundreds of them. And this app lets you put together your own version of the song. So in terms of nature, it's obvious this is about crystals. And musically, it's about musical structure. Now let's take a look at one of the other apps. The second single to come out was called Virus. So Virus is completely different. Like, just like our universe, there's a huge variety of visualization styles in this app. So this one is an under the microscope simulation. So you can see me drag around cells by their nucleus. It's as if you could touch everything you see under a microscope. So you can drag around these cells. There's a viruses coming in, and they're trying to attack the big cell in the center. Now, it's a kind of game. You can take the viruses and fling them away to try and protect the cell in the center. But what happens is that if you successfully protect the mother, then the song stops. So the song starts just kind of hovering after the second verse. So the only way to hear the whole song is actually to lose the game. You have to let the viruses attack and win. There's also some accompaniment. You see the other nuclei singing along. So we've got a pretty strong dichotomy here between, you know, poetry and science. On the one hand, we tried to make everything as scientifically realistic as possible, and, you know, even use a simulation instead of just a movie. But on the other hand, you know, we change the scale of things. Nuclei don't sing, and so on. So it's just like any kind of storyteller, you know, you have to find the mixture of metaphor and realism to tell the story. See, now the viruses start to open up and they inject DNA into the nucleus. So not everybody knows how viruses work. In fact, some people don't even know viruses exist or deny their existence, and they die because they know. So I mean, I'm not trying to say this app saves lives, but you never know. So the DNA comes in, and again, you can fend off the infection by pushing the nucleus around. But eventually the DNA penetrate, they start to hijack the DNA replication mechanism of the cell to create more viruses. Each of these apps also has an instrument mode where you can play along. So this plays samples from a hang performed by Mano de Lago, like, you know, maybe the best hang performer in the world. And some of these play samples. These are gamelan. And these, I bet a lot of people in this audience have never seen this thing we used to call a tape, which is something that spins along and pulls magnetic tape and plays a song. But that references, you know, this old way of playing music. And I'll show you a couple others. I'll give you a little preview of a couple of the apps. The whole project's going to be released on October 12th in the App Store. And this is Thunderbolt. So this app is about electricity, and that's very satisfying. So you can make these little sound effects. Obviously, all the audio in this app is very highly curated by Björk and the engineers that work with her. Wow! And this is a kind of lightning drawing program, so you can. Open-ended. But the main attraction in this app, the main musical aspect of it, is about arpeggios. So you can put down two fingers and it plays an arpeggio. So the height corresponds with the tempo. Thanks. And then lowering it makes it go slower. Raising it makes it go faster. And if it's shorter, then it's just one note, then two notes, three notes. So, I mean, have you ever seen a more fun way to learn about arpeggios? You can also put down multiple fingers and then make non-sequential arpeggios. And there's also a way to play along with her song. Back to the page. And I will show you, I'll give you a quick preview of one other. This is an app called Hollow. And this one was created by TouchPress, which created the Elements app. And this is a kind of drum machine. This is DNA replicating. And you can click on these different proteins flying around, and they queue up on the left. And then as they scroll down the DNA and then enter this replication, they trigger a sample. So it's a kind of drum machine with this kind of primordial sound of our ancestors. Now, this isn't it. You could actually talk about biophilia for a couple of hours, but I wanted to show you one more thing about this project. Björk was actually using a bunch of instruments that she made herself when she performs the concert live, and one of the instruments is a Tesla coil. The Tesla coil that performs the actual bass line to the song in a semi-safe manner on stage, as long as it's not raining. Now, This is arguably the first app album that anyone's ever made, and it's brought up a lot of questions about you know, music and art and the music business too. One of them has been whether it's a good idea for music to be interactive. You know, that these artists have a clear intent. So is it a good idea for people to play around with it? Now, one thing I want to mention is some of the reaction that we've been getting from people who are downloading the app album and listening to it, because, again, I bet some of you in the audience have never had this experience, but you used to buy an album and you'd have to take it home to listen to it. It was this big, you know, 12-inch object, and you'd have to put it on your stereo and then stay near your stereo while you listen to it. And this experience is kind of like falling in love. It's like a first date with an album. You know, you sit there, you listen to the album, you maybe listen to it twice. While you're listening, you read the liner notes, you look at the big artwork, and you're completely immersed in the music. Now, that very rarely happens to anybody today. First of all, few people are even buying albums. Well, I mean, they're not even buying any music. They're often stealing it. But even if they're buying music, they just buy a single song and listen to it, you know, while they're walking down the street or so on. So it's almost like you've short-circuited right to this maybe too much familiarity with the music, where it's just a background part of your life. You know, it's kind of like a casual relationship. You know, you've kind of missed out on the falling in love, the getting to know each other part, and go straight to like kind of waking up in the morning and brushing your teeth. So I think that's one of the beautiful aspects of this Biophilia. You know, an iPad even kind of looks like a little bit like an album, is that it gives you this chance to fall in love with music again and have it completely engulf your senses.